Right, so Jess is with us now. I went, oh, that looks like fun. She goes, yeah, I love getting up early. It's great.
I do, yeah.
It's sarcasm, your default mode.
That's really mad. I'm really bad at getting up.
Are you? Yeah. What happened? So like, how many alarms?
I woke up at 5:30.
Yeah.
And then I must have just turned it off. So, like, it was just really lucky that I woke up.
Did you get that
45
fear?
Minutes later, I was still late.
Did you get that fear in the pit of your stomach, you know, when you're late?
When I woke up, actually. Like, imagine I didn't wake up.
We'd have been very disappointed.
Yeah. Well, and then I woke up and I was like, you know that gasp with air, your heart's like racing, yeah.
We all know that feeling. Yeah, we should explain to people, you've got an excuse for feeling a bit tired this morning, because you were on stage last night.
Yeah, I was, yeah.
Yes.
In Manchester.
Do you remember?
Yeah,
do you remember?
Sorry.
You were supporting the Spice Girls.
Yeah, I was there last night. It was amazing.
Yeah. How was it? Describe it. So you open the set. You start the whole show.
I do start the whole show, yeah. It's so amazing. You know what? Standing in the stadium's incredible. And, like, the crowds are so big even when I go out. It's incredible.
You've performed lots, but what was it like having Spice Girl fans in the audience? Because they're of a different ilk, a different
it's
era
really
in many
weird,
ways.
Do you know, I think yesterday was the first time I think it really hit home a little bit, just because I was a really big Spice Girls fan, like huge, yeah.
Who was your favourite?
I don't know who was my favourite. I think I just was a Spice Girl fan.
Very diplomatic.
I don't know. I do. I love them all. And it's so weird because it's like, it's a really weird moment. Like when you stand and watch them and you hear the songs and it literally just takes you back, like, however many years ago that was.
To all the emotions you had with every song.
Yeah, I don't know, I just feel like a little girl.
Yeah.
And so, like, coming out on stage, and obviously all these people are here to see them, but I'm kind of... I can't explain it. You can see I'm a bit...
It's like, you're like a fan and performing. It's like,
yeah,
best
it's weird.
Of both
and then
worlds.
You're, like, talking to them, and I'm like, this is really weird, because, like, you're... Yeah, it's weird.
Well, so give us a little insight then. You say you're talking to them. Do you kind of? I don't know how this works when you're a support artist, you know, with a band. Yeah. Do you spend time with them? And immediately before, are you kind of having a little drink or food behind the scenes? what goes on?
I didn't actually get a chance to hang with them until yesterday.
Okay.
But yeah, no, they're all really cool. Like, we don't really. I mean, it's a really big stadium, so it's like we're all kind of dotted about. So
what does Jesslyn look like just before you're about to go on? Are you all quiet and zoned in, or are you kind of pumped
I'm usually,
up?
Usually, like, running really late, rushing around, like,
I'm seeing a theme
here.
Yeah, that's me. I always make it on.
What do you make? I've got to ask you, because there's been loads of anticipation about them performing. But there's been quite a bit of criticism about the sound problems and everything.
Yeah.
You've been there. What's going on?
I'll be really honest
with you. Yes, please.
I honestly think it's, like, a load of rubbish. The show, I promise you, I wouldn't just say it. The show's amazing. I genuinely, like, walked out on the first night to watch the show, and it honestly, like... It was so emotional. And I think, you know, people always try and find something.
But Mel B or Mel C, I think, actually said, we're going to sort out the sound next time. Hopefully it'll be better in Cardiff,
like,
I think they said.
The sound's... Like, I watched it last night, and if there was any problems, I didn't get to watch it in Cardiff. I don't know what happened there. I don't know.
No, they're going.
But I've got to tell you, it's great.
So...
And I'm not just saying it because I'm on the tour. It is great, and it sounds fine, and... The show's wicked.
You've got your own album out right now.
I do.
And tell me, can you just, there was problems with your voice, weren't there? You lose your voice just recently.
Do you know what it is? My voice gets tired. So, like, when you're working and you don't get a day off, like any normal person, it just gets really tired. And then people are like, oh, you always lose your voice, this, that and the other. But it's like, when you sing, right, the best way I can describe it is a bit technical. It's like, your voice, yeah, your muscles, right? They vibrate when you talk and when you sing. So, like, when you sing, they vibrate, like, a million times. Like, they're, like, a million times harder than when you talk. So if you're, like, performing and then you're doing promo and then you're performing, it's,
like... And then getting up to do interviews in the morning.
I do this just because that's what they look like. They're literally, like, these tiny little things that, like, go like that. So, like, when you're working pretty much 7 days a week and your voice is being used like that, it's really tired.
It's tired.
And that's all it is, and it's, like... People think, oh, no, you lose your voice, oh, my God, this, that, and the other. It's, like, it's pretty normal when you're being worked really hard. It's not, like...
Well, you hear about opera singers having to have operations and all sorts because they're using it so much.
Yeah.
We can... Let's have our viewers listen to your latest single featuring Jax Jones called One Touch. But you're making me laugh this morning because you have no idea where you are at the moment.
You know,
you're all over the place.
I know. Disoriented, isn't it? Yeah, sorry.
But no one, you see, that doesn't matter. The only thing anyone cares about is what you deliver on stage. And I, from reading what people say about your performances, you go for it, don't you?
Yeah, I'll always go for it. Always. No matter what. Yeah. 100%.
You love it?
Yeah, I love it so much. It's frustrating when, like, you know, you're tired and whatever, but then the minute you get up on there and you get, like, the feedback from the crowd, it's like, yeah, let's go.
Are you back on stage tonight? You're doing
it? No. Oh, so, I'm chilling tonight. I'm going to...
What does that look like when you're chilling out?
I'm probably going to, like, leave here and go to sleep all day, I think. I think sometimes, do you know, I'm just being real. Sometimes I feel like you need to just...
No, you do.
Have
you
bed
do.
Days, yeah.
You do.
So we're going to do that. And then tomorrow,
DVD or streaming
Yeah, probably,
site.
Like, Netflix. The Bodyguard I just started on Netflix. What if you...
I urge you just to be a little bit careful as you step off our platform here.
Right.
Because your platform shoes... I don't know whether we can see these. Look at that. That is a serious heel
it's
on there.
It's a big one.
Just it's taken you back, Charlie, hasn't it?
A bit careful. Yeah, we used to call them wedges.
Wedge. Yeah. It's a big old wedge.
Yeah.
Good
to see you this morning. Thank you for waking up.
Yes. Yeah,
just
been
in
great.
Time.
Thank you.
I like you. Jess Glynn's single is called One Touch. So